So this is when the Arab era begins here in the city. So we pass through the Al-Aqsa Mosque and the Dome of the Rock. That is, it's a very holy place both for Jews and for Muslims. Actually, the city is also known as Al-Quds. It's the third holy city in Islam, first being Mecca, second being Medina, and the third one being Jerusalem. So we began with the Umayyad Empire. The Umayyads are the ones who built the Dome of the Rock in 691 by Abd al-Malik in Marwan. My Arab viewers, because I know that you guys watching me, please let me know which part of the Arab world are you watching me from. I'm sorry if I don't pronounce very well this name in Arabic. It's really, really hard. Abd al-Malik in Marwan built the Dome of the Rock. And I've seen this mistake being made. They call it the Mosque of Omar. Well, Omar didn't build it, and it's not a mosque, it's a shrine, which according to Islamic tradition, it is the place, guys, where Muhammad in Surah 7:1, okay, ascends up to paradise. So, and then in between 705 to 715, the Al-Aqsa Mosque is built by Abd al-Malik ibn al-Walid, I mean the son of Abd al-Malik ibn Marwan. Yep, this is we're talking about the Umayyad Empire. Guys, I'm passing over here because we have another gate over here. This is called Flower Gate. It's also called, because it's a rosette on top, it's also known as Herod's Gate. No idea why, because there's no connection with Herod, and we don't even know when it was built. But anyway, we will continue because I'm gonna make a video on this gate. So the Umayyad Empire lasted here until 749, actually 750 to be technically correct, because another empire will rise. The capital of the Umayyad Empire was in Damascus. The Abbasi Empire will rise, and that is Baghdad. Sadly, during the Abbasid Empire, during this time period, the Holy Land, Jerusalem is neglected. That's why we do not have basically Abbasid deciding another city called Ramleh. Any Abbasid structure in the city. So after the Abbasid, from 750 all the way to the Middle Ages, basically, we have that, because then they will come the Fatimid capitals in today Cairo, until a very sudden change. Yes, it was very sudden. So someone else will come to power in Europe, come over here in this 1099, the Crusades guy. Yes, it's a sad story of the city, but it is what it is. Sorry to my European friends, and if you're watching me from Europe, please let me know what country in Europe you are watching me from. But in 1099, the Crusaders will come and they will slaughter the inhabitants of the city, Muslims, Jews, even Eastern Christians. In a different video, I will speak about the Eastern Christians, who they are, and the different group they are, because the Crusaders were Catholics. My beloved Catholics, followers, yes, it's part of the history. It is what it is. I can't change history. I cannot rewrite history. So in 1099, the Crusaders came, they slaughtered. So the population of Jerusalem will shrink.
You can write new history?
No, you cannot. You can write the history, but you cannot rewrite the history from the past.
Only if you have a time machine.
No, no time machine. That's a Hollywood, baby. So 1099, they established a kingdom. The Al-Aqsa Mosque will become a church. It was called Temple Dominus, the Temple of the Lord. The Al-Aqsa Mosque will become a palace, the Temple Solomon. That's how the Crusaders renamed it. But they are here, at least here in Jerusalem, until 1187. This is a very important day, because the 4th of July of 1187, Salah Adim, and I hope I'm pronouncing it right, or the closest that I can pronounce his name, Salah Adim, will defeat the Crusaders up in the north, okay, in a place called the Horn of Hittin. He take Jerusalem back. Jerusalem goes back to be an Islamic city. The Crusaders will continue, guys, on the coastal plain, and the capital will be Akko.
And in the future, I don't know when, but I will, God willing, if I'm alive, and I hope to do so, I will make a video, and it will be a different part, because Akko is huge. And but Akko also will be included on my second book. Talking about my second book, it is a second book because I wrote a first book, right? So my first book is on the city of Jerusalem. It's an artistic book. God, if you want to support this channel, you can go to the link below and you can get a copy of my book. Okay? So, and I can sign it for you, right? The signature is free. Oh, thank you very much. Thank you. I'm posting over here, guys. Put here to the left, because it's closed. It's called Sedekiah Escape. Again, it's a folkloric name. Sedekiah was one of the king of Judah. It's actually the last king of Judah. But it's amazing. If you wanna have an idea, what this warrior that used to be here, the magnitude. You can go there. It's not free. It's quite an entrance fee. But it's humongous, guys. Humongous. So I invite you to go see the guy's case.
Okay.
All right, so where was I? Oh, I was with the crusaders and being defeated by Salah al-Din. But Salah al-Din defeated them, Jerusalem goes back with me and his army. Simple. What we call now this time period, the Ayyubid Empire. That was the family of Salah al-Din. So his empire will last, I mean the Ayyubid Empire will last until 1250. These dates are important because then we have another one who rising to power. Oh, but the Muslims, the Mamluks, capital Cairo. So the Mamluk, and guys, when I do a video on the Muslim quarter, I have to say to my Arab and Muslim viewers, guys, I love Mamluk architecture. And we have lots of it in the old city, especially in the Muslim quarter. Of course, we can't compare it to Cairo. Cairo was... I'm sorry, guys, my throat. Can I have some water, please?
Sure.
That's why she's my assistant.
And now can I say something? To get your comment in a video, the only thing you need to do is ding the bell, follow him on Instagram.
Yes, if you want to follow my work in Instagram, there's the link below.
Comment when you're done, and you'll put your comment in the video.
Exactly. So my little assistant, can I have some water, please?
Sure. Do you want any soda?
Yes, please, because my throat is getting dry. It's been over. It's been like 27 minutes. Okay. Guys, I really hope that you enjoyed this video, okay? So the Mamluks are here. Mamluk architecture, beautiful. We cannot compare the architecture of the Mamluk to Cairo. Oof, man, it's like comparing also the architecture of the Roman architecture here with Rome. We just got it. Can you hold this, my assistant?
Yes.
And can you tell them something about yourself to them?
I don't know.
Yeah, just tell them your name. What's your name?
Halel. Hello, Andrea. I have two names. My Spanish name is Andrea, and my English name, well, my Hebrew name is Halel. That means...
Where were you born, Andrea?
I don't know.
Where were you born?
Oh, right here in Israel.
No, by which city?
Jerusalem.
Oh.
And my two sisters were born in the same hospital, the same nurse, and the same room. And I was born in a different hospital, different room, and different nurse.
Yeah, that's very good. Thank you. Thank you for sharing with us. Oh, that's my little one.